Scratch, a high-level block-based programming language that has been around for 20 years. It's also technically a social media. With hit games like Fruit Flip, Ship, Flappy Mario, Minecraft, and... Wait. Splatoon, Flappy Mario, Minecraft, and Minecraft, it's very popular.
And because of its popularity, I decided to take it upon myself to make a game in Scratch with no itching powder-related experience. Camera chance. And I'm talking no experience. I've never made a game in Scratch.
So that's exactly what I did. Apparently, Scratch is a downloadable app, so that's what I did. I just downloaded it. There's nothing special. And then I immediately began doodling.
But unfortunately, I didn't record footage for the doodling session.
Which is good, because I ended up drawing some treacherous things. But the process ended like this. Wait a second, this gives me an idea. Fish. You already knew that based on the thumbnail. But for me, it was an epiphany.
So I'm editing right now. It just started raining like really hard. Yeah. Okay, back to the video. The initial art had a fish with eyes, and I changed that. I'll tell you later.
Oh, yeah.
But right away, I got the guy swimming around with a lerp function. I would be lying if I did not look up the Unity documentation for it. Yeah, so then I tried to add the eye, but for some reason, I couldn't get it to follow the fish. It just kind of became a fin eye. That being said, the game is pretty unpopulated, and it doesn't have a clear goal. So I spent an infinitesimal amount of time thinking about what I should add next. Hooks and worms. I know, I'm a genius. You can send me my Nobel Prize at these coordinates that are on the screen. Now, I'm not the best artist. I apologize for any eye bleaching you're gonna have to do after this video. But nonetheless, logically, I drew a hook and I drew a worm. Actually, no. I drew the hook and I coded the functionality for gravity and then I added the worm. With the gravity, I created a variable for the velocity. So I made the hook randomly spawn in at the top of the screen, just not where the player could be. And then I did the same logic for the worms. Next, I added a scoring system for the worms, which when you collect a worm, the score goes up. It's so simple. I don't know why.
Although technically I shouldn't have done it next. What I did was polish. Not Polish, polish. Let me explain.
This is a sine wave. In a normal sine wave, over time, the y value journeys between 1 and negative 1. Because of the consistency in the value change, us nerdy coders can use the y value to our advantage. So I did just that with the bubbles. As you can see, the bubbles move up and down, and that's using the sine wave. The bubbles are also influenced by the mouse position, which makes the fish swimming around feel more satisfying. It was at this point when I realized that the hooks actually could not kill you, but all of the footage is super laggy. You can blame Adventuremase for that one.
Hey guys, welcome to the Adventuremase official yap sesh.
So I made the death screen say womp womp. I know it's kind of political, but I do want people to start talking about it. And the game has no sound! So I'm gonna fix that by making music. I don't even know what I'm doing here. The song ended up sounding like this.
That's all you get. Music doesn't grow on trees, you know. Wait a second. What am I wearing? Lactose merch. For a limited time, it's 25% off and the link is in the description. It's not actually lactose merch, as you can see. It's just a shirt. So then I added the corresponding sound effects for collecting a worm and dying to the pointy thing. How do you like them? Probably not at all. I just grabbed random ones from my sound effects folder. And so the game is done. Or not. I still don't have a name for the game.
So I spent some more time in rumination and I geniusly came up with fish, worms, and hooks. I know, I'm still a genius, and no, I'm not reusing this footage. I spent a relatively short amount of time making the logo, and then I set up the Scratch page. And now the game is actually done. You can play it via the link in the description.
It was a nice change of pace to make a short game because I'm used to making long and big projects. Long and big? Because I'm used to making big projects like Night and Mourning and Tiny Gnome Game. You're cool. You'd click the links in the description. That being said, buy Lactose merch and watch this video right here. Also like and subscribe.